Hey guys, what's poppin'? Jacques Slade here, and today I have a shoe that, if I'm going to be totally 100% honest with you guys, I'm not sure you're going to like it, but I like it, and really, I guess that's the point of it all, that I like the shoe because I'm the one that's gonna wear it. Anyway, I just thought you guys would want to take a look at it, so let's do that. Let's go. For those that don't know, this is the Nike Air Max 270 ISPA. And before I get into this shoe, I gotta give you a little bit of history. So the Air Max 270 first released in February of 2018. It came in a bunch of different styles and different colorways. And the shoe represented the first time that Nike made an Air unit specifically for lifestyle purposes. Generally, when Nike makes shoes or when Nike makes product, there is a performance focus and people end up wearing it in a lifestyle sort of sense, but with the 270, it was strictly a lifestyle unit and not something that you were really supposed to technically run, work out, train, or anything like that. And it was really just a shoe for you to wear around and flex. But like it happens sometimes, the 270 wasn't necessarily well received. Even though, to be honest, I felt like the shoe was one of the most comfortable silhouettes that released in 2018. There's a lot of different varieties of sneakers, but the 270 was mad comfortable. But because the 270 wasn't well received, I think that put it in a place where the shoe could really succeed in a way that other silhouettes couldn't. Now, to be fair, the shoe didn't do terrible. People still buy the 270. I see people walk around in 270s all the time now. But I think with it not just going crazy, I think it allowed Nike to really play with the silhouette and do some different things with it. And that's where we get this shoe, the Air Max 270 ISPA. For those that aren't familiar with ISPA, it stands for Improvise, Scavenge, Protect, and Adapt. And what they're doing with silhouettes like these and a bunch of different other ones is really taking a traditional shoe and creating it for an athlete, but not the traditional athlete. They're looking at the city dweller or the person that wears lifestyle silhouettes and Nike sportswear gear. They're looking at them as an athlete and what they have to do. So they're tuning silhouettes like this for the rigors of that person that's walking around in the city all day or that's living their life in the city all day. And part of that is evidenced by the outsole. So it has these huge nubs on the outsole. If you're walking around in the quote unquote concrete jungle, you're gonna need a lot of rubber on your shoes. And that's where this additional rubber plays in here on this model. You see here at the top on the orange and at the bottom in the black. Now going back to the ISPA really quick. Now that's not necessarily a category. It's more like a theme or an ethos, something that Nike designers want to design around. They have a bunch of different people from different categories inside of Nike that are working on the ISPA projects. And what they're doing is thinking about sustainability, thinking about how a product is used, thinking about how a product's afterlife, and incorporating all of those things into a later design, which obviously results in something like this or the other silhouettes that we have seen. For this model in particular, it has a very sort of like hiking boot sort of aesthetic, even though it does still have like that sneaker style to it. They have this orange upper here, and this one in particular is orange, but they have a black one and a white one as well. And it's like this plastic with loops at the top. And what they've done is taken this paracord style cord and driven it all the way around the orange to help keep you locked in. And you actually have the ability to tighten the cord around your foot through the line here in the back. It has almost like a lace loop here in the back to kind of help with that as well. Keeping with that utility approach, the shoe underneath or the material underneath is actually waterproof. So if you get water on these, you don't have to necessarily worry about water seeping through, so that if you're in the rain or if you step in a puddle or something like that, you do still have some protection. On another note, they have this reflective area back here. Again, it's all about utility, and if you're living in the city, that reflective part back here helps people see you at night when their lights are shining and things like that, so you have that extra added layer of protection on your shoes. Design-wise, as you can see, it is something that is a little bit crazy, to be fair, but they have like these exposed stitches back here. They have these ribbons and they have these orange ropes here. It's just these little touches that kind of give the shoe an almost unfinished or rough or utilitarian sort of presence, which is something that I really like and something that I really picked up on when I first saw the shoe. Now, completing the hiking aesthetic, you see we have these round laces, which is something you generally find in hiking shoes or hiking boots. And again, gives that whole ACG, that all conditions geared, but also still like a lifestyle vibe to it, which is something that I really gravitated to when I first saw these pop up. They were originally priced at $180, and at the time I wasn't willing to spend that amount of money, but I made a stop over at the outlets here in my city and I found these there on clearance for $100 plus an additional 20% off. So all in all, I ended up paying about $93 with tax to get a shoe that I was really looking forward to and that I really wanted to get my hands on. I'd literally been watching these on sneakers and on Nike and watching the prices go down, and I was gonna see how far down they would go before I actually pulled the trigger, because I knew it was a silhouette that I wanted, but I just wasn't willing to pay full price for them, at least not yet. And being able to find them at the outlet at the price that I found them for under $100, I'm definitely excited about these, and this is something that I'll probably be wearing when I go to France this week, just because I think it's a cool silhouette. It has a very cool lifestyle and fashion vibe to me, and if you rock it with the right outfit, you can really flip it and make it into something totally new and a little bit avant-garde that everyone else isn't going to be wearing. Lastly, there are a ton of Nike swooshes on this shoe. I don't know if you've seen them from me holding them up and from the B-roll, but you see there's one here, there's two on the inside, so the orange on the inside is one swoosh, and then they have the black, that's another swoosh. There's another swoosh here, and then there's a swoosh on the inside as well. And if you didn't believe there were Nikes, they have Air Max here at the bottom, kind of sealing that whole Nike Air Max theme. Now, overall, I think this is a very dope silhouette. I didn't pay full price for it, which makes it even doper in my mind, but it is a silhouette that I wanted to get my hands on as soon as I first saw them drop on sneakers. Is it something for everybody? No, this is definitely not a shoe that everyone's going to rock or everyone's going to want. But I think that's the beauty of the sneaker world. You're able to get something that you personally like. You don't have to worry about what everyone else likes. You can buy stuff that you like and you rock what you rock. So I'll be definitely rocking these. And if I go back and they have the black or the white colorway at this same price point, I'll probably be grabbing those as well. Anyway, so I just want to give you guys a quick look at these. Again, this is the Nike Air Max 270 ISPA. It's mad comfortable. I've already been wearing them around the house since I got them yesterday, but I wanted to do a quick video to give you guys a quick look. As always, make sure you like, favorite, and subscribe. And if you really like what you see, why don't you go ahead and turn on those notifications. I'm Jacques Slade. As always, I appreciate you, and I'll see you soon. Peace.